morning, everybody. Happy Saturday. It is 9:46 in the morning. I was going to try to go to Steinmark this morning, but they don't open until 10. And I got to get my sister-in-law a birthday present because tomorrow we're going to my mother-in-law's house for dinner. Because, you know, I've told y'all this. The ones that's been subscribed to me for a while, y'all know this. My mother-in-law, she always cooks dinner for her sons and daughter-in-laws for our birthdays. So her little thing is tomorrow. I can't remember if her actual birthday's tomorrow, but I know the birthday dinner is tomorrow. So I got to get Melinda something, and we're dealing with some weather. So right now it's not raining, but it has rained all night long pretty much. So, yeah, I'm trying to get out in this before it gets real bad, because I don't really want to be out in it really anyway. Plus, I have other things at home I really need to be doing that I'd rather do or whatever. But, so I guess I'm taking you guys along with us, and we ended up having, I had Taco Bell last night for dinner, and the kids and my husband and all had McDonald's. So, I finally got my Taco Bell fix. That's the news update right there. Okay, we're almost to the Walmart. And Gina, if you're watching this, I'm gonna look for that 14-day cleanse that she was telling me about in the other vlog's comment. So we shall see. Okay, so in the same shopping center that Walmart is in is the little Dollar Tree, which is back here. And then there's a Burke's Outlet. And I think I'm gonna run in there real quick and see if I can't find something for Melinda in there real quick. And then if I don't, then I'll just head on over to the Walmart. Okay, so we went into the last place I showed you. What's it called? Burke's Outlet. I got her some tablecloths. Kind of fallish looking. They're really cool. I'm going to get her something else. I also went in the Dollar Tree real quick and got her a bag and a card to put it in. But I want to pick out something else extra. This is my bag sitting beside me. If you're wondering what this is. There's Jaden trying to be a creeper. A photo bomb or whatever. But anyway, I want to get something else and for her. And then we'll be done with that shopping aspect. Okay, so I did find this Gina was talking about. So that's like 10 bucks, 9 something or whatever. And we're over here on this candle aisle. And they've got new tablecloths out too over there, but I don't think I'm going to get any of them. I've seen. Does it?
Yeah, really good.
Mm-hmm. Some out maybe.
Oh my gosh. Look at this candle, Mommy.
Yeah, those are actually like warmers and stuff. They've got all kind of groovy things times 10 in here. I'm trying to see what else they have that might be fall-esque, so to speak.
Told you about.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Yeah. They have a lot of books down there. This is the other thing I'm going to get Melinda right here. It's all shiny. She'll like that. Okay, so I think we got out of there just in time because it's starting to mist again. So that's what our clouds are looking like right now. And this is the parking lot there. So you can kind of see what we're dealing with here. So I need to get, it's 11:17, so I basically need to get the kids home and let them have lunch. Yep, construction over there. Jaden's crazy about construction sites. Okay, the lighting's not that great in here since it's so dark outside, about to rain, but this is those placemats, and you can kind of see that little sheen to it. I didn't even realize there was four. There's five of them. Their youngest child, she probably doesn't even sit at the table, but I guess it'll be all right. But yeah, this is what the price is compared to $20, but so that was the other thing I got. Right now I'm waiting on this to kind of start bubbling a little bit. I'm going to make some of this for lunch. The kids are in there having their stuff. And yeah, there's that stuff there again. So I'm deciding when I'm going to try this. So, yeah. So, Jaden's almost done with his lunch. Have you already started on your popcorn?
I'll eat that last.
What are you doing, Levi? And y'all see the living room is all disarray. They've been in here playing. So I've got to clean up some of these toys. They get lost under the couch. Move the couch out of the way. Fill that basket up. It's about time to rotate the basket. Yeah, we got pink roses out there. You can kind of see them there. So really, that's why it looks so, what's the word, gloomy and dark in the living room like this. So I think after they eat lunch, and I have lunch, I don't know if I'm going to take a nap or try to watch some TV or something. I'll figure out dinner. It's like always what I'm talking about, ain't it? Okay, so I got Melinda's stuff all done. I actually wrapped her little pumpkin plaque in some of this tissue like that and stuck it down in there, and then just taped her little card to it there. So her thing's ready for tomorrow. Okay, so it is a little after 4, I think. Yeah, like 4:03. Let me go get Levi out of his room. My husband just called and said he's on his way home from work, which is early on a Saturday. What, buddy? What you doing? I went here and turned his light off. He's done playing. I had put him in here because I was mopping the floor in the living room under the table and all that in here earlier. So it was like just vacuuming and all that, and then mopping under there, and then I came in here. I had to throw some towels or whatever in there, and I took out my mop bucket after I used it, and I still got to put those dishes away, and this is what the kitchen's looking okay for right now. But I think I'm going to make for dinner some fried shrimp, and you only have to run cold water over it, over the shrimp. Sorry, I found a Fruit Loop or something here. Cheerio or something. Fruit Loop, I think. Or maybe it was Apple Cheerios in his seat. Anyway, you only have to run cold water over it to begin with. Golly, I look pale looking when the light hits me like that. I need to take off this nail polish. And let me just sit down here. Y'all never have me where I sit down very often. What, Bucky? You're so cute. You waiting for the daddy to get home? Yeah? Say yes, ma'am. Yeah. He's learning to nod his head. He'll say yeah sometimes. Once he gets his syllables down, he'll be saying yes, ma'am, and no, ma'am, and yes, sir, no, sir. That's how we teach him. But, anyways, I guess I'll probably just do... He's got to be in the picture thing, too. I'll just do some cheese grits with it. And I got some baked beans, some Bush's baked beans, I think, up there in the cabinet. And that'll be it. We don't have fries or anything like that, but... Golly, I don't even feel like... I don't even feel like doing anything right now. So it is 5:03. I started getting the shrimp and everything ready to fry just a little bit ago, and I've got some towels in the dryer, hand towels, that kind of thing, kitchen towels and rags, and they're drying now. And I don't know if some of you just don't know, but I'll tell you how I do fried shrimp. So I just get the bag, you know, it don't really matter, the process is the same, but like I just buy the bag or the frozen kind at Walmart and just run some warmish cool water over them, and they thaw out really quick, and strain the water off of them, and then just put you some flour. In this case, I've just got some self-rising flour in a dish right here, because that's just what I grabbed. And then I put them in there, toss them around, shake off the excess, put a little bit of oil in your skillet, and throw them in there. Now, some people would call that done right now, and they really probably are. But we like ours what you call fried hard. And yeah, And be careful about if you put any salt on them before they cook, because they absorb salt like real easily. So I usually just don't do that because you can taste them better. And fried shrimp is the only way I eat shrimp. I know other people eat them different ways, but that's the only way I can tolerate them. But anyway, that is what's happening right now. Oh, and by the way, I always buy the peeled and deveined shelled raw ones. You gotta make sure they're raw. Don't, if you're new to this and it says cooked, then, and you buy the wrong thing, then you cannot fry them because they're already cooked. So, and another thing is the way to know when they're done really is their tails will kind of curl up like that right there. And so yeah, I've got, you want to fry them in batches, otherwise they can, you know, turn to like mush on the coating on them. So, and some people will soak them in buttermilk and then put flour on them. I don't do all that, just regular flour, or, you know, just whatever you have. Flour, nope, no cornmeal, nothing like that. That's for fish, so. and then we're having some cheese grits and some Bush's baked beans. I usually make homemade baked beans, but I'm saving time, yay, for saving time. So I'm just making some baked beans in a bowl in the oven. I mean, microwave oven. And it should be done here in about another minute. And then I'm going to microwave some grits and put some cheese and all that groovy kind of stuff in there. And it'll be time to eat. And I'll show you what it looks like when I get it all plated up. So this is how it looks when it's all plated up. This is actually mine. I'm just going to have mine with this, as I'm the only one that eats cocktail sauce. So yeah, can't really tell, but that is cheese grits and some baked beans and some fried shrimp. Well, we are done eating dinner, and I'm coming out here. It is really windy and breezy. I don't know if it's the mic on the camera is picking it up, but it is. Oh, I'm feeling a mist of rain. It is misting rain now. Whew, I got my door. My door's propped open to the kitchen to kind of let some heat up, but that rain is blowing in on me now. But come out here to end my vlog. That way when I'm done doing the dishes, just got a few little things to do that I didn't do. I like to do dishes as I'm cooking, and that way I don't have as much to do when we're done eating. So that's what I'm just going to do and finish up and edit this video. So thanks for watching, you guys. If it's a crappy video, I apologize. I have no idea sometimes what I'm doing, but thanks for watching anyway and spending time with me on the vlogs, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.